97% of the water in Gaza are unfed for human consumption. So the water situation in Gaza is really horrible, and I'm exploring solutions and alternatives all the time to try to help. But it's impossible to do anything in Gaza without lifting the blockade and freeing the people and granting the freedom of movement and the people to be able to bring resources to build and to live normally. Actually, I haven't seen my family in 2 years, and it's really tough time right now, and I can't be there with them. And so this is what we need to do. We need to, first of all, to lift the blockade, and then we will find solutions to everything else. Without lifting the blockade, it's really hard to navigate any solutions for all the problems that and the crisis that Gaza is suffering from.
And your thoughts on Razan being killed the day that the U.S. vetoed the U.N. Security Council resolution on protection of Palestinians?
It's really disappointing. It's the whole world is watching one country of occupation bullying everyone else, and no one is doing anything. It's such a shameful it's a shameful side that the United States decided to take, and it's really disappointing. And we wish that they would rethink this and would work toward justice, because peace will never emerge if we keep acting the way people act and the way the political leadership in the world acts. We need people to seek for justice, and this is how peace will be built.